someone want to come up there with me?
Yeah.
Hey, looks like there's a harpoon ship on the horizon.
There's another one.
It's
just to the right.
It's another harpoon ship.
Now the Bob Barker is surrounded by faster harpoon ships on all three sides.
We've got harpoon ships coming in close on port side. Make a bit of tempo.
There's three harpooners all just coming up behind us now, like three rabid dogs lining up pieces.
Where's the third one at?
Real close in on the port quarter.
Okay.
That dude's coming closer, definitely. And looks like he's actually speeding up.
Is he?
It's a high tension moment to know that we're isolated in a hostile environment and we're not amongst friends.
Closing in on it.
Yeah. You could feel them just starting to, you know, chase like a pack of dogs showing up. And the tension was just, you know, palpable.
Mal, this side's headed right towards us.
He's turning into us?
What the f*** is that?
Whoa, look at that.
Oh, I see it.
Whoa.
Yep.
Oh,
7 o'clock.
Another Japanese ship has appeared. The Bob Barker is now seriously outnumbered.
Which ship is that? Does anyone get an ID?
I'm working on it. It's the number two.
The ship that's directly off our port quarter now is definitely the Shonan Maru number two.
The Sea Shepherds have confronted the Shonan Maru number two before. Both the Steve Irwin and the Ady Gil have already had fierce engagements with the reconnaissance ship.
When the Shonan Maru number two was tailing the Steve Irwin, they continually, days on end, took aggressive action against that vessel. You know, if they do come in any closer, we're going to assess that as a threat and act accordingly.
The Sea Shepherds fear that the four vessels are here for one reason, to keep them away from the Nishin Maru.
Them now closing all really quick.
Now, four whaling ships surround the Bob Barker. Their chances of staying with the Japanese factory ship seem to be deteriorating quickly.
There were four ships that are designed to hunt and kill large mammals maneuvering aggressively around us. We all were prescient of the dangers that were being presented to us.
We're coming up on both sides.
We had all three harpoon ships and the security ship on us. It was our one vessel against five ships, knowing that we were too slow to keep up with the Nishin Maru. It was so important that the Ady Gil was on our side.
Now, the speedboat, the Ady Gil, is the Sea Shepherd's only hope of staying with the Nishin Maru, but they only have 30 minutes of fuel remaining.
Bob Barker, this is Ady Gil, 11.
Yeah, Ady Gil, Bob Barker, you're loud and clear, mate.
We've got just enough fuel to get up past these guys and hassle them a little. And after that, probably watch you guys come by.
If you can slow them down a touch, that'll help us greatly. Thanks, Pete, all the best with it.
Yeah. Well, Ady Gil was getting low on fuel. But Pete Bethune did some calculations and he said, okay, we may have one last chance to engage these guys.
The Ady Gil will use their last drops of fuel to make one more attempt at prop fouling the factory ship. This time, they'll use a rope that's been reinforced with steel cable.
It'll be a short, sharp burst from us down here, and then we've probably got to leave the party. It might be like the party's just getting going, you know, like the alcohol is flowing, there's a lot of hot babes in that there, and we've got to go off and pick up our mum from the theatre.
If the prop fouler fails, the Nishin Maru will speed into the distance, leaving the Sea Shepherds behind. Then the harpoon ships will easily be able to transfer whales to the factory vessel at will.
Yep, all good, mate.
We are heading for the Nishin Maru to do one more attempt with our prop fouling line, but We gotta hurry up because the harpoon ships are on our tail. You know, we're a very fragile ship. We can't afford a collision with one of the ships, so we gotta speed it up a bit. We might have one shot at the Nishimaru, and that's it.
Couple of minutes, guys.
I felt pressure to deliver. You know, Paul Watson and the Sea Shepherd team put a lot of faith in us, and I didn't want to disappoint them.
You ready to release the propeller?
Yeah.
Drop it now, tell me to drop it now.
Release the propeller now.
Come on, let it in. Come on, come on, come on. They slowed down, they slowed down. There's something going on. Still don't see the boys coming out.
They
stopped, Mike. You're the master pilot. Good
time, man. See, we're only doing 15 knots now and we're gaining on them quite quickly, so I reckon they've basically stopped. Which is good news.
Marco, this is Ady Gil. Just letting you know the Nishimaru has stopped.
It's all clear, Pete. Nishimaru has stopped.
Yes. It was a heck of a roller coaster because we thought we were done, and here we are back in it. And it was awesome. It was amazing.
Let's head straight at him then, eh, Mel?
Yeah.
Now's the time to make up some ground. Seeing the Ady Gil stop with the Nishimaru just reaffirmed for me why the Ady Gil was the most important tool of this campaign. You know, a lot of my hope was put on that vessel. And I saw it perform spectacularly.
As long as one or other of our ships is firmly kind of attached to the stern area of the Nishimaru, then the hunt is over. And if we can maintain that position for the next few weeks, then the entire season's over. And that's what we're here to do.